are so glad for such a wonderful turnout. My name is Erin Jericho. I'm the director of the Brown Bag Concert Series, which is part of Westport Center for the Arts, which believes that when the community creates art, the arts create community. And our ongoing message is to find beauty and meaning right here in Kansas City. And we do that with the different programs that we offer. So in the back of the church, as we leave today, you'll see some wonderful paintings by Stan Morgan. So we sponsor art openings by local artists. We also have readings, play readings that are produced here by local playwrights. And I get to be in charge of the music. And this, our Brown Bag series runs from September through May. We have classical music, jazz, and folk music. So we welcome you here today. As you came in, there's a portion of charge, but we rely on donations. So as you leave today, there will be a basket at the back of the church where you can leave a donation if you choose. Also, this year we're very excited and we're grateful to the board of the Westport Center for the Arts because we brought back our receptions after the concerts. Of course, for a couple years there during the pandemic, we weren't able to have receptions, so we invite you to please join us for the reception after, which will be right up here. You can talk to the artists and visit with each other. Inside your program, you will find a survey. And we ask that if this is your first time or your last time, that you please fill that out. That helps us with our grant writing. And also, I forgot to mention, another program, the other event that's really cool that we do is the Dancing Bird. So that is coming up right after Easter. That's April 5th and 6th. And that is also inside your program. So, this Brown Bag series started with Mary and Thomas. And so it's just a joy for us musicians that she's invited to be with her today to do her final program. And I invited her, I wanted her to come up and talk just briefly about how she started the program, a little bit of history, so that you know, and then we'll begin our program. So please join me in welcoming Mary.
When I came to this church as organist, it was 1994, and at the time I was a preschool music teacher at the Purple Dragon, and I wanted children in the Willow Woods Daycare Center, Child Development Center, which is next door here, to have the opportunity to hear live music. And so I started inviting them and created the Lunchtime, the Noontime series. And their favorite, their children, they were a wonderful audience. And their favorite was always the Haunted Organ Concert. Because they got to wear costumes and they got to parade up around while the organ played marching music. That was a lot of fun. In the beginning, the performers were all volunteers. I called on friends and a symphony program. The Kansas City Symphony had a program called Community Connections. And symphony players came to play got points, and at the end of the year they got a little extra pay for their community service. The Westport Center for the Arts was created in 2006, and so the Brown Bag series was incorporated as part of that program, and it has continued. I directed for 21 years, and then I was thrilled to find Vera Farrago, who has directed for the last 8 years. So we're in the 29th season. And I guess my favorite program over the years has been the Dubtown Quartet, which comes to celebrate the Martin Luther King holiday. And that has gone on for 24 years, consecutive years. I hope that continues. So I hope I'm great and happy to see you. I thank you for coming and congratulations.
Thank you.
successes are. And I have 20 children, but only 10 of them lived to adulthood. And so he was well acquainted with grief. But he believed very strongly that upon death, one entered a realm of peace and joy. And so some of his most beautiful music was written around themes of death. And this variation 25, about out of the 30 that he wrote on the same beauty, uses a musical motif to express grief. People in Rochdale and Belichick studied Greek rhetoric. And in Greek rhetoric, different speech patterns are used to express feelings, or to evoke certain feelings in the listeners. Well, the musicians of the Baroque era used different motifs to evoke different emotions. And if you ever hear that Bach's motion is not emotional, I think I'm not hearing music. Most of what we played was pretty joyful, although there were some quiet moments, but this piece evokes grief. But there are some moments of joy within it. And the motif for grief was to jump up an octave. And he does this in the first section of this piece 5 times. When you repeat the section, you have 10 of those. How many children did he lose? I don't know. You know whether he was thinking that or not, but I like to think that. And then in the second section, I was expecting another 5 weeks, something like that, but there are only 4 of them. I almost forgot. I wanted us to practice that motif so that in the music, you know, if you're sad, you take a breath and you sigh. So I want us to do a communal song. The way we're going to do this is we're going to take a deep breath in and then we're going to just go. Good. Communal sigh. All right. So in the when there are 4 of these reeds in the second section, he goes all the way to the high D on the harpsichord, very high. And then he takes us down, the sigh is so deep it goes down 3.5 octaves and ends down there. So I want you to think when that note ends and the last thing that dies away, are you feeling grief or are you feeling joy and peace or maybe
the sections, it's too slow. It's marked adagio.